Tonight, as we join once more, a beautiful message taken from Mahashiv Katha, Mahashiv Puran. Once more, for the past two nights, we have been understanding so much in depth from our scripture, where Bhagwan Shiva not only teaches the kahanis, the morals, the values, but in depth how to live in this world. You see, the blessing of Bhagwan Shiva has taught us the very essence of life itself. Life is not just the simple things that we see, but beyond the simple things, there are greater things that we will find. A beautiful message begins as we start the night, where Bhagwan Shiva, he sits with Parvati Mata in Kailash Parvat. They are looking down on the earth and they are seeing people living their lives. And while everybody are living their lives, they are looking into the lives of everybody as to what actions they are performing, good and bad. While people live in the most appropriate way according to scriptures, dharma, the sattvic way, there are those who will know which is right but yet live a bad path or live a bad life. As we say, sometimes people try to correct us and we say, well, I know, you know. But do you do the right thing? Well, I didn't get a chance yet, but I know. Don't worry, I know. One of these days. We all know which path to take. We all know what is right. And God said to us when we were about to come in the world, before we came into the womb of our mother, Bhagwan showed us our appearance. And he said, when you go on the earth, this will be your mother, this will be your father. Do you promise to cherish them forever? And he said, Prabhu, I love my parents to death. I will cherish them forever. And he then said to us, while we will come in the world, give me your promise that when you go into the world, you will not forget your duty, your role, to worship me, to respect me, and in turn, one day, merge and become one with me. And we said, God, I promise you. God then said, due to the karmic ashrams of your past life, you will take birth in this world, but when you take birth, it is said, due to that moment of childbirth, a child cries out and screams out in pain. He says, you will come into the world and you will remember everything, but due to the pain of childbirth, you will forget everything. But there will be one thing in particular that will remind you as to what is right and what is wrong. You will have that thing that is called a conscience. When your conscience beats you, it means you have done something wrong already. You have done the same thing already and it was wrong. And now that conscience is telling you, don't do it again. Because if you do it again, when you go to the patal worlds, you will be scolded and beaten for what you have done wrong. But when your conscience guides you correct, it means that the Divine Lord is showing you a right path. While the Katha begins, it begins in a wonderful kingdom where there's a king and there's a queen. They're ruling their kingdom most beautifully. They're giving charity, they're giving alms, they're being the best. They have and they can give. While you have, give back to the world. Give, my friends, because when you give, you will receive. Do not give with the expectation of receiving in turn, but give and you will receive. And when you receive, don't ask for physically receiving, but spiritually take it when you leave this world. While the king and his wife, his queen, they would give back to the world. They had everything in a kingdom, except one thing. They would like to have a child who can take over the kingdom one day, but they're not blessed with a child. They have gone to their guru, and the guru have advised them, in order to clear your paths, the first thing that you must do is turn to your parents and worship them. Turn to your mother and father and respect them. When you turn to your mother and your father and you respect them and you love them, and a mother could smile at you, everything will work out in your life. When a father could smile at you, everything will work out in your life. But if a mother says nothing will happen for you, book it, not even the gods coming around you. It is reality. I've seen many people who have fallen on the ground so low where they can't even pick themselves back up. I've seen people fallen on a bed in a hospital and they're lying there sick and they can't even move. And they will remind themselves and remind the people around, my hand cannot move, but this is the same one I hit my mother. My foot cannot move today, probably I'm paralyzed, but I remember when I abused my mother and my father and I kicked them out. The blessing of a mother and a father goes beyond the gods and the devatas. It is said devatas will wish to come on the earth and take birth just to feel the love of a mother. Just to get the dular. What is dular? What is dular? Nanda dulare aao raju dulare. Nanda dulare aao raju dulare. He says, parte ke sainat darshan dejo. Parte ke sainat darshan dejo. Ishwaram bala darshan dejo. Ishwaram bala darshan dejo. Om Namah Shivaya. सूरत सावरी सूरत मोहन सूरत ओ मोहन सूरत सावरी सूरत नंद दुलारे आओ राजू दुलारे नंद दुलारे आओ राजू दुलारे ईश्वरम बाला दर्शन देजो ईश्वरम बाला दर्शन वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की नंद दुलारे आओ राजू दुलारे व्हाट इज दुलार पेटॉप हाउ मेनी पीपल लाइक पेटॉप एवरीबॉडी लव्स पेटॉप Every child likes to go my mother and father and hug them up and mommy play with me here na. Mommy pat me on the back na. Mommy love me na. Everybody wants petup. Everybody wants to feel loved at some point in their life. And who better to give that love than a mother and a father? Is it true as we say? Nobody will love a child like mother and father. While the dular will be transferred, katha begins where? Mother and father, king and queen, they want to have this child, but they cannot have a child. They've been sent by the guru to go by their parents and wash their feet. When last you washed the feet of your mother? When last did you wash the feet of your father? When last did you do aarti to your mother and father? When last did you touch the feet of mother and father and simply say, bless me, ma, bless me, dad? As a matter of fact, when last did you take up your phone and say, Ma, you okay? When last did you say, Dad, you all right? Dad, everything is okay? Dad, do you need anything? When last, my dear friends, did we show our mother any form of love? Listen, while they've gone to their mother and father, they prostrated and they're about to worship them. And this is what happens. Kabhi ma baap ki seva के नहीं सिर्फ पूजा से करने से क्या फायदा एवरीबॉडी बोलिए कभी प्यास को पानी पिलाया नहीं बार अमृत पिलाने से क्या फायदा कभी जीते हुए को उताया नहीं बार आंसू बहाने से क्या फायदा क्या एवरीबॉडी बोलिए Let me see your hands tonight. Remember, by clapping loudly, you are cleansing your aura, you are cleansing your heart, and you are preparing for the blessing of the Lord.
मैं तो सत्संग गाया पूजा आरते के पूजा करने सुवे ये दयाल गया मैं तो सत्संग गाया पूजा आरती के पूजा करते हुए ये ख्याल आ गया कभी माँ बाप की सेवा की ही नहीं सिर्फ पूजा से करने से क्या फायदा
हर हर गोविंदा
गंगा नहाने हरिद्वार काशी गया गंगा नहाते हैं मन में दयाल गया गंगा नहाने हरिद्वार काशी गया गंगा नहाते हैं मन में दयाल गया तन को दो मगर मन को दो या नहीं सिर गंगा नहाने से क्या फायदा। कभी माँ बाप की सेवा की ही नहीं, सिर्फ पूजा से करने से क्या फायदा। मैं तो सत्संग गया पूजा आरती की। हाउ कैन यू ऑफर आरती टू द गॉड्स एंड यू निग्लेक्ट योर मदर एंड फादर? हाउ कैन यू ऑफर प्रेयर टू द गॉड्स बट कभी माँ बाप की सेवा वर्शिप टू मदर एंड फादर के ही नहीं? यू डोंट डू इट, यू डोंट रिस्पेक्ट देम, यू डोंट लव देम, यू डोंट वर्शिप देम। Two individuals are seated by mother and father. They are washing their feet. They are putting chandan. They are offering essence. They are offering arati to mother and father. And all respects are given. It is said they turn around and they are now going back to their kingdom. When the guru would then advise them and he says, now you take a seat. You sit down by yourselves, both of you. And you close your eyes. You forget the world. And you pray to Lord Shiva. Bhagwan Shiva, the guru of all gurus. That is why we say, Om Karam Baba, Om Karam Baba, Om Karam Baba, Om Namo Baba, Manasa Bhajare Guru Charanam, Dostara Bhavasa. He is the guru of all gurus. He is worshipped on the day that is called Guruvar, Thursday. And while we worship Bhagwan Shiva, both of them sat down. They then sat in meditative posture and they started to pray to Lord Shiva. Panchakshara mantra, Om Namah Shivaya. They would then continue with Mahamrityunjaya mantra. How many people know Mahamrityunjaya mantra? Put up hands. How does it go? All right, wait, let me start over now. On this side, chant Mahamrityunjaya mantra. After 3, 2, 3. Kya baat. So we'll turn this side to be the Shivites, devotees of Lord Shiva. Everybody on this side loudly, Mahamrityunjaya mantra. Baba, do help them, eh? Kya baat? Gayatri mantra. Alright, let me put some love in it now. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tatsavitur Varenyam Bargo Devasya Diyo Yona. What does it mean? I always tell my devotees, what does it mean? Today is the day where devotees worship Bhagwan Surya. It is said this mantra pertains to Bhagwan Surya. It is said, Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha Tat Savitur Vareniyam. Lord, bless my eyes, my nostrils, my lips, my ears, my hands, my feet, my heart, my head. Bhargo Devasya Dimahi, and as an offering, Diyoyona to the entire being of the universe. Prachodayat. Bolye. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha. Kya baat? Bhargo Diyoyona. Om Bhur Bhuvasvaha. Tatsavitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona. Gajananda Swami ki. Every day, this king and queen will sit down, they will light their diya and they will pray. Every morning, they get up, they offer dhar. They will sit by the lingam. Every afternoon, they will light their diya. How many people light their diya on an afternoon? Put it up high like this.
जय भगवान. वॉन्ट टू रिवर्स आर यू. व्हाई डू यू लाइक दी एनी आफ्टरनून? When you light it in the afternoon, zombie don't come in your house. And if you don't light that dia, you might turn a zombie. What is the essence of lighting the dia? As a child, we grew up lighting a dia at 6 o'clock in the afternoon, not so? What made us stop? It is said at 6 in the afternoon, Goddess Lakshmi passes everywhere. And to those who have that light lighting, she will feel respected and she will enter that home and she will bless the entire home with wealth, prosperity, happiness. What is wealth? Money? Not only money. Wealth of happiness. Wealth of joy. Wealth of success. Wealth of my friends. Everything that makes life meaningful. Light that light. Light the dia. And what do you say? Siddhi buddhi prade devi. Mahalakshmi namostute. Do you know how many people don't know that mantra? It is a universal prayer. Do you know how many times we go to puja and we ask sometimes devotees in the family, well, here's what, we're going to light the dia now. Say siddhi buddhi. Baba, which one is that? Siddhi Buddhi Prade Devi. Baba, that is the one that ends with Om Namah Shivaya? No, beta. Then how many devotees sit down to do a puja and after offering prasad, we chant, Shri Guru Charana Saroja Raja Neja Mana Mukura Sudhare Varanam. बुद्धिहीन तनु जाने के क्या बात. सियापति रामचंद्र के जय शरणम. बजरंग बली की. And when we hold the prasad and we say बजरंग बली की जय, Baba says put the prasad by Lord Hanuman ji. Baba, which one is Hanuman ji? Is it this one? How many of us are falling short when it comes to our culture? How many of us don't even know to identify the deities? How many people don't even know the difference between Satnarayan Swami and Suryanarayan Swami? Who is Lord Satnarayan Swami? Baba says we're having Suryanarayan Puja. Bring the picture, the murti of Lord Suryanarayan Swami. Baba, which one is that? Sometimes they bring Lord Ganesh too. Which one is that? And then I remind devotees the question, is it Surya Narayan Swami, Suraj Narayan Swami, or Suj Narayan Swami? Which one? A, B, or C? Or D, I don't know. It is Surya Narayan Swami or Suraj Narayan Swami. Suraj means the sun. But what is Suj Narayan Swami? Jai Bhagwan, I don't even know. We have tried to rush saying Suraj, that we say Suraj Narayan Swami. Suraj Narayan Swami, Surya Narayan Swami. How do you know the sun god in an image? The sun travels throughout the universe. So when he sits on his chariot, he rides on a chariot to go everywhere. He will hold the reins of the horses. He needs the horses and the chariot to travel. So Surya Narayan Swami sits in his chariot and he holds the reins of horses. Who is Satnarayan Swami? He's an incarnation of Lord Vishnu. So he stands looking like Lord Vishnu, and around him you will see the fig plant. You will see the fig tree. You will see a sadhu in front doing Havan Puja. What is the purpose of the fig plant in the Bedi? Two reasons. The fig tree represents Lord Vishnu. And the second reason, it is the tree of life in the universe. How is it the tree of life? It is the only or one of the only trees that when it grows, it will bear only one time. When it finish bear, what do you have to do? Cut it down. Symbolizing the one life we have to live in this world. And after we live that life successfully, we will receive the fruits of our actions only once. That blessing. Because after that, margaya, we die. The essence of so many things in our scripture. While they sit down to pray, they are praying to Bhagwan Shankar. And they are praying. One day has passed. 2 days have passed. A week, a month, years are passing by. But yet they are not getting their blessing. How many of us pray and we say, I don't know how much more to pray. I pray every day and yet I'm not getting answers that I want. How many of us are praying every single day and while we are praying, we are ready to give up?
Do you remember?
It is said in that time where holy Phagwa came into existence, the little Prahalad, he stood up to his father. And when he stood up to his father looked everywhere and he says, son, all you want to do is worship Vishnu Bhagwan. Where is your Vishnu? He looked at that table, your Vishnu there? And he took his sword and he cut that table in half. Well, where is your Vishnu now? He then looked at a vase and he says, is your Lord there? And he took his sword and there he hit at it and he broke it. Where is your Lord now? And there he went to the pillar. And he saw the post, the pillar in the kingdom. And he says, is your Lord there? If your Lord is there, then tell him come out. And who came out?
Namaste Narasimhaya. Prahaladaladadayine. Hiranyakashi Purvakshaha.
Who's he?
Half man, half lion. He's called Lord Narasimha.
When he came into the world, he's teaching the world with your faith, with your prayer.
Be persistent.
It is said Prahlad stood and his father decided to break up everything. Where is your God now?
If we say prayers today and we don't get the answer tomorrow, we say Tahano God.
How much faith you have? Being persistent is the key to the answers of the world.
Listen, my dear friends. Namaste Narasimhaya. Namaste Narasimhaya. Pahaladaladadayene. Hiranyakashi Purvakshaha. Hiranyakashi Purvakshaha. Shilatantana kalaye yato narsimha parato narsimho yato narsimha parato narsimho yato yato yamita to narsimha bahir narsimho hridaye narsimha narsimha madim charanam prapade savakar kamalavare nakam arbuta shinga dalita hiranyakashipu tano vrinda keshavadrita narahari rupa jay jagadish hare jay jagadish hare jay jagadish hare tavakara kamalavare nakam arbut singa dalita hiranyakashipu tano vrinda keshavadrita narahari rupa jay jagadish hare jay jagadish hare jay jagadish hare केशव देता नरहरि रूपा जय जगदीश हरे 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 जय जगदीश हरे
वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की
लॉर्ड विष्णु केम ऑन द अर्थ एंड देयर ही बिकेम हाफ मैन हाफ लायन. He became Narasimha.
We must be persistent in our prayer. Don't be ready to give up at the slightest of problem and trouble, my friends. It is said, while this king and queen are praying, days and weeks and months and years are passing by. And realizing that no answer is coming, they will be persistent and they will continue.
While they're continuing, in Kailash Parvat, Bhagwan Shiva sits down. His eyes are closed and he's in meditation. While he's in meditation, Parvati Mata sees this couple praying. So she takes her elbow and she nudges him.
Prabhu, kya hua? Bata do na, dekho, look. Look down there. Your devotees are praying so hard. Days, weeks, months, years. They're praying for a child. Why don't you attend to your devotees instead of sitting and just praying whole day, meditating whole day? Why don't you get up and actually do something for those who are worshipping you?
And he opens his eyes.
He says, Devi, they were not blessed to have children in this life. And he closes his eyes and he continues. She couldn't settle for that answer. She nudged him again. Hare, utna, get up, listen, wake up. Look at your devotees praying so hard. Why don't you go and bless them? He says, Devi, didn't I tell you they can't be blessed? Because of the actions of their past life, their karma does not permit them to have a child. And if I say they can't have a child, they won't have a child. She decides at that point that she's head bent. They have prayed enough and you will have to go there. He decides that if you want to insist that I must bless them, no problem, let's go to the earth. He decides to come down to the earth and he's coming down. And while he's coming down to the earth, he goes down to that spot where the king and queen, they are praying. And he stands before them and he's waiting for them to open the eyes. And as soon as their eyes are open, listen according to the beautiful verses of Mahashiv Puran.
Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om.
Everybody, bolo.
Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om.
Bhagwan stands up before them and the Lord Bhagwan Shiva says, because of Parvati Mata today I will bless you. You will be given the birth of a beautiful child, a wonderful son. But I will bless you with that child, and because you are not supposed to be blessed with children, there's one condition. You will be blessed with this child, but this child will only live for 12 years. Only 12 years. They said to themselves, 12 years is better than no child at all. So they put their hands together, they pay pranams, and they receive that boon of Mahadev, the boon of a wonderful son.
Kare he huparatana da karaloka sune ke bharotana hita jan loka. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om.
Altogether, bole.
Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya Namah Om. Namah Shivaya, Shivaya.
Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki. They have been blessed with a child, but that child will only live for 12 years. If your child, and if you know that according to the destiny of your child will live only for 12 years, what will you do? Jai Narayan. What will you do? No one may be able to bear just knowing that. And even after knowing that, Raja and his queen, they are taking care of the child. And while they know it's 12 years, one has passed, two has passed, three, four. four, five, six. The 11th year has come. What would one do in such a situation? What would you do if you know you have 1 month to live? Pandit ji say he could spend out all the money. What would you do if you had 1 month to live? Some people might say pray whole day and night. Some people spend out all their money. Some people try to create peace amongst those who you have enemies with. What would you do with 1 month to live? This child is growing up. 11 months has come. He doesn't know he will live only till 12 years. But mother and father, they are looking at this child, knowing that he will live only till 12. 11 and a half comes. 11 and three quarter comes. By that time, they probably get in junjuni. They are, as we say, fish out of water. They don't know what to do. They don't know how to live. They don't know how to react to the situation. The last month has come. And what do? Not being able to bear that situation, it is said the king calls his brother. And the brother comes to the kingdom. And he sits down with his brother and he starts to tell him what the reality of life is for them. He says, from this point, I want you to pick up my child. And I want you to take him on a pilgrimage. I want you to take him to Banaras, Kashi, Varanasi, as it is called. It is the abode of Lord Shiva. And I want you to take him there. I will give you money. I will send with you a chariot with many things to offer. Food, fruits, gold, clothing. And take him there and allow him to make the greatest offering that he can make. To those who've been to Banaras or Kashi or Varanasi, it is the place of Lord Shiva. It is said the minute you step out of that train and your foot stops or steps on the earth of Varanasi, you hear people all over. Are bam bam bola! You hear the damru on all corners. They are all Shivais. They are all devotees of Lord Shiva. And you hear the chanting of Om Namah Shivai. They're walking everywhere. The presence of Lord Shiva is felt. And then you go to the biggest temple there. There are two big temples. You go to the temple of Lord Shiva. And in the temple of Lord Shiva, Kashi Vishwanath Mandir, it is said the doors are made out of gold. And you will enter into the mandir, and when you walk in there, the dome of the temple is made out of gold. And you will walk in and see different lingams, and there's that huge lingam inside there. Pandiji, you were there? And when you go by that lingam, you will see all the pandits everywhere, and you will walk up to the lingam, and you will hold your prasad, and you will say your prayer. And as I remember it, just like yesterday, Jai Bhagwan, I will give you my experience. While you were walking into the mandir, if you were walking empty-handed, you will be walking there and you will see people outside. Bhaiya, you're going to Lord Shiva empty-handed? Bhaiya, take a little something to offer, man. Look, we have little cups of dahi, cups of milk, take something, offer. Really? Of course, offer to Bhagwan Shiva. Bam bam bola. And you will take the offerings and you'll be so excited. And you'll reach up to the top and they'll give you a little tarya, big like this one. Just like this. And it will be made out of leaf. And you'll have a little dia inside it that could last just half an hour. And you will then be given the opportunity to now pick up one of this. And you'll ask them, hey, how much? Are you go pray na man? Okay. And you'll go to Bhagwan Shiva and you'll walk in and see the murti or the lingam of Lord Shiva. And when you walk up to the guru, you reach up at the front and you'll say, Gurudev, I'm ready to make the offering to Lord Shiva. He'll walk up to you and he'll grab the parasad from your hand and he'll throw it on Lord Shiva like this. And you'll say, but I didn't pray yet. Well, it's okay. Guru Dakshana now, come. Are ready? I didn't pray properly yet. Guru Dakshana already. And you'll stand there and probably put your hands together and you'll say a prayer. But while you're saying that prayer, Om Namah Shivai, he will come and touch you. Hey, pray one side now. Pay this side and let somebody else come. You see things? When Mahashivratri comes, what opportunity do we get? We walk up to the lingam. We can offer prasad, take it with our hands and put it by the lingam by our own hands. We can take our own flowers and offer it. And even then, we complain. The line too long. Even then we complain while we are standing in the line. I don't know why they're doing so long. but the energy of that hate and that frustration is going into the prasad. You will stand and you will offer the prasad and they will throw the offering and then they will put you one side. And then you will turn around and you will give them Guru Dakshina. And you will walk and you will see all the different lingams and you will just go and touch it and bow. And next time you say, you touch a lingam, Dakshina. Again? Yes, if you touch Mahadev, you have to put Dakshina. Okay? Put Dakshina. Do pain and they will tell you, they will shrap you. So you must put Dakshina. And then you'll walk outside and you'll say, Bhagwan Shankar, well, I didn't know it was like this, you know. So you put your hands together, Om Namah Shivaya. And you ring the bell and you walk outside and one come, hey, you ring that bell? Guru Dakshina, boy. Jai Bhagwan. And then you'll say, well, I have to take it out now. I don't want to be shrapped. And then you'll pay for that. And when you walk outside, everybody who gave you the milk and the little prasad and the arti, how was your prayer? Good? Well, right. 20 rupees for the milk. 50 rupees for this one, the Tariya, 50 rupees. Do pay na, they'll run you down. How blessed are we? We get the opportunity to be here. We are here tonight. We are blessed. We are given this moment to clap, to chant, to sing, to be awakened spiritually. We are here to awaken our energies, our strength. And yet we just sit here and we allow knowledge to just disappear. Friends and bhaktas, when opportunities like these come, never allow it to go by. It is said, mother and father, king and queen, they're seated there and they're about to pray to Bhagwan Shiva. Their son is going to Banaras, Varanasi, and they know it is the last month. And in order to pray to Mahadev, Bhagwan Shankar Bholenath, it is said they take the opportunity to sit down in meditative posture and they're praying. This son has gone to Varanasi and he has gone to Kashi Vishwanath. And while he's praying to Bhagwan Shankar, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. Everybody, Umapati Mahadev ki. Loudly, Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Shankaram, Shankaram, Vanchitamaram, Bhajata Varavaram. Shankaram, Shankaram, Vanchitamaram, Bhajata Varavaram. Chikalam, Chitkalam, Vanchitakalam, Namata Hatamalam. Shankaram. Har Har Mahadev. Manasa drita bahu bhavanam manasa manasa drita bahu bhavanam nana jivana nolasanam nana jivana nolasanam shankaram shankaram vanjitamaram bhajadavaravaram shankaram shankaram vanjitamaram bhajadavaravaram. Everybody bole, oh. Om Namah Shivaya. Karuna gya Karunagya Drita Bhuvanavanam Karunagya Drita Bhuvanavanam Avagati Vitaranam Matakala Mataranam Avagati Vitaranam Matakala Mataranam Shankaram Shankaram Vanditamaram Bhajadavaravaram Shankaram Shankaram Vanditamaram. Oh! Oh! Har Har Mahadev. Kamadam, Drita Madana Madam, Kamadam, Drita Madana Madam. Kamadam, Drita Madana Madam, Kalika Ramadam, सचिदानंदम कलिका प्रमदम सचिदानंदम शंकरम शंकरम वंदितमारम भजत वरवरम शंकरम शंकरम वंदितमारम भजत वरवरम 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 शंकरम महापति महादेव की They have gone to Bhagwan Shiva's abode. It is said that child, 12 years old, on that brink of 12 years, the day has come. He walks up to Lord Shiva. He walks up to the Lingam. And there he sits down. While he sits there, the uncle who took him there, he walked away because he went to make an offering by a different murti. And while the child sits down by Bhagwan Shiva's Lingam, that child starts to pray. He offers flowers. He offers some of the prasad that he walked with, some of the fruits. And when he made the offering, he sat down there in a meditative posture. He's ready to pray. He's ready to chant Om Namah Shivaya. But he starts feeling dizzy somewhat. The day has come. The moment has come. Do you know when your day will come? Do you know when that moment will come? One of the most popular verses of Guru Adi Shankaracharya. संप्राप्ते सन निहिते काले नहीं नहीं रक्षते दुक्रिन करने What does it mean? संप्राप्ते, when the appointed time comes. Which appointed time? The time of death. नहीं नहीं रक्षते क्या बात? रक्षते means? Raksha means, what do you call this in your hand? A raksha. What does it mean? Protection. From who? Protection from who? From all negative forces. When you do a puja and the guru or the pandit gives you the raksha, he says a mantra and he puts that raksha there. When he says that mantra, that devata will reside there. So if he says Hanumanji mantra, Lord Hanumanji will reside there to protect you, wherever you go. If he says Lord Shiva mantra, Lord Shiva will be there to protect you. If Lord Shiva resides in this hand because you have a raksha, and Lord Hanumanji resides there, can you take that hand to eat? And I'm not talking about corn, eh? Can you take that hand to eat? What am I talking about? Krishna's fresh cooking, right? KF. Can you take that hand and eat that? Immediately you are disrespecting either Lord Shiva, Lord Hanumanji. You are disrespecting that God there. And instead of the God working for you to protect you, He can work against you because of disrespect. So then you can get sick. Illness can come. Do you know how many people sometimes comes, Baba, I'm not feeling too good. I don't know. I went to the hospital. I'm there making all the checks and yet I can't find out. Nobody knows what is wrong. Okay, have you been fasting? No. Take out this from your hands. And in no time, Baba, feeling good, you know. No big magic. It is said the gods become disrespected because it is there. Every night when I'm going home, and that is why I mention it tonight. Every night when I'm going home, everybody know where I'm living. I pass through Princess Town. And in Princess Town, there's a big Krishna's hut. Krishna fresh cooking hot. And while I'm passing every night, I notice how many people are walking with the hands filled with bags and you can see it out boldly. As long as that raksha is there, you disrespect that God. For your benefit of health and protection, if you break your fast, take it out. We like it for style. It look nice. Well, good. Give me one now. You're fasting? Oh, no. Take it back then. If you're not fasting, do not keep it on. You'll create more problems. You must be fasting to have that deity to protect you. Some people say, no, the mantra was a different mantra, so you could keep it on now. Which Hanuman mantra go in and say, Jai Bhagwan? As long as God is there, purity must be there. While this child sits down by Bhagwan Shankar, he's praying, but the moment has come. That last moment, That final moment has come. And while the final moment is there, Bhagwan Shiva is above, Parvati Mata is above. She knows the day has come and she will not let it pass like this. And while this day has come, they are coming down now. Parvati Mata says in her mind, I allowed you to give this child life. I will not allow you to take it. So she comes down at this spot and she's searching. And while she's searching, the child seated by Lord Shiva feels dizzy until gradually he starts to sway to and fro. And suddenly, he falls down right next to the lingam. And when he falls down next to the lingam, devotees who are around, they realize that something is wrong. They walked up to the child and they now touched him by the shoulder, but he didn't move. They started shaking him by the shoulder, but nothing happened. They're trying to call him, Beta. He doesn't move. Just like the snap of a finger, my friends, life can go. Samprapte sananihite kale nahi nahi rakshati. We can put up the biggest burglar proof in our home for the thieves. We can protect our homes with the best surveillance. But when the God of death is about to come, you cannot protect yourself. You cannot run nowhere in the world. You cannot hide nowhere in this world. It is said when that moment came, the God of death is about to come. Bhagwan Shri Krishna, the Lord of the universe, is about to come down. And while he's about to come, listen, my friends. Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara Govinda Hare Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara Govinda. When someone dies, the Lord Krishna comes there. The God of death comes there. Lord Krishna is standing, the God of death is standing there. And the soul is about to leave the body of the child. While the soul is about to leave, Bhagwan Shri Krishna waits. Parvati Mata comes down at that point and she stands up and she says, no. Today that child would not leave this world. Bhagwan Shri Krishna says, ask Mahadev, the time has come. He is called the Lord of time, Kal. He will tell you the time has come. Nobody could stop it. She says, well, I am Parashakti and no soul will leave without my permission. No soul can leave this world without the permission of the Divine Mother and without the permission of the Bhagwan Shankar Bholenath. While Lord Shiva stands there, he sees the soul leaving and holding the hand of Lord Krishna. And Lord Krishna says, it is time now to leave. Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara Govinda Hare Gopala Hare Hare Govinda Hare Gopala Hara Hara 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 Govinda Hare Gopala Everybody bolo Govinda
हर गोविंद हरे गोपाल हर हर गोविंद हरे गोपाल हर हर गोविंद हरे गोपाल
वृंदावन बिहारी लाल की
हर हर गोविंद हरे गोपाल हर हर गोविंद हरे गोपाल ओ
गजानन स्वामी की जय।
इट इज सेड व्हाइल द सोल कम्स आउट द सोल इज गोइंग टू भगवान श्री कृष्ण मदर पार्वती गोज टू लॉर्ड शिवा एंड शी सेज लिसन टू मी दे से वन वुमन स्पीक वी हैव टू डू लिसन राइट
She says, Prabhu Shankar, Bhagwan Krishna, God of death, today you will give back this child. You're not going to take this child. This child did what was right according to all the Shastras. He did what is supposed to be given as an offering and he sat down there humbly making offerings to you, Mahadev. Do not take advantage of the devotees. Advantage? I gave him life to start with. He wasn't supposed to be born here. I gave him 12 years. What did he do?
And your mother now says, and listen tonight, there's this beautiful mantra I love so much.
It is a mantra that says to those who can give this mantra as an offering to Lord Shiva, then even at the time of death, he can bring you back.
Despite some of you just walk like the living dead already.
He can give you once more renewed life. He can give you once more a second chance. If your life is messed up and things have gone haywire, as we say, he can give you that second chance. He can allow you to start back and rebuild and become the best.
But listen to this mantra. Ahimsa pratamam pushpam pushpam indriya negraham sarvabhuta daya pushpam kshama pushpam visheshataha शांति पुष्पम तपो पुष्पम धानम पुष्पम ततेयच सत्यम अश्वविदम पुष्पम विष्णु प्रीतिकरम भवेत। व्हाट इज द मंत्र सिंबलाइजिंग एज एन ऑफरिंग दैट द चाइल्ड गेव टू बी एबल टू रिसीव लाइफ वंस मोर।
ही सेज लाइक अ फ्लावर विद 8 पेटल्स ऑफर दिस फ्लावर टू लॉर्ड शिवा। व्हाट कैन अ फ्लावर?
द फ्लावर ऑफ लाइफ।
Ahimsa pratamam pushpam. Firstly, practice ahimsa in your life. Don't hurt people. Don't hurt them with your words. Don't hurt them with actions. Do not hurt people at all. Practice ahimsa. When Gurudev would walk in India, he would walk in such a way that he would make sure he doesn't even mash a hand. Because you do not hurt even a life. When we take bop,
Jai Narayan Swami.
How much do we end?
Bhagwan says, Ahimsa pratamam pushpam, pushpam indriya negraham.
Bhagavad Gita chapter 15 says, Manashastani indriyani prakrishishani karshati sharinam miravapnoti yachamut kramatishvaraha. Manashastani indriyani. Indriya means our senses. Control your senses. Know when to stand up. Know when to back down. Know when to get angry. Know when to create peace. He says, Indriya.
Ahimsa pratamam pushpam. Indriya negraham.
Sarvabhuta daya pushpam. Be compassionate to those. Kshama pushpam. Forgive people. Learn to forgive and forget. How will you be able to live and move forward in life if you cannot forgive and? Baba, forgive him or not?
But I want nothing to do with him.
If you want nothing to do with him, then you never forgive him. To forgive means that you release everything. I can talk to him now normal because I'm not bothered about whatever had taken place. I have forgiven him.
Kshama pushpam, shanti pushpam, visheshataha.
Shanti means
peace. Be peaceful.
Tapo pushpam,
danam pushpam.
Meditate, do your prayer, do your service, do your community service, do seva to the prayers, to the yajnas, to the mandirs. Practice japa, tapo, pushpam. Dhanam pushpam, give dan, give charity. Satyam pushpam, speak truth at all times. And ashtavidam pushpam. And that will be the 8 petals of the flower that Lord Shiva wants. Practice that. And God can give you a new life once more. It sounds easy, but not many people can practice that. Ahimsa, Indriya Negraha, Daya, Kshama, Visheshataha, Shanti, Tapo, Danam, Satyam Ashtavidam. Practice this, my friends, and see how beautiful life can become with the blessing of our Lord. That child, it is said, stood there, and Parvati Mata held him by the hand, and she says, you can go back into the body. Your mother and father, they are crying and waiting for you in their kingdom. It is said he entered back into the body, and when he entered there, he turns around, he gets up immediately, and he starts walking. He sees his uncle, and he holds his hands, and he says, now, I want to go back home. Please take me home. And while he's about to go home, friends and devotees, listen what happens. He's about to go back home, and while he's walking home, he sees on the top of the palace, his mother, the king, and the queen, they're standing at the top of the palace, and they are ready to jump. They want to behead themselves. They want to kill themselves. They want to destroy their life. You know why? Because they cannot bear to see the uncle walking alone and coming back, knowing that their son would have died at the age of 12. And as they're about to jump, waiting, as they saw the uncle, behind the uncle, they saw none other than that child. It is said the child is smiling, and he run goes to his mother and father. And as he runs to them, they would have come down, and they embraced their son. And they looked up above, and they are now saying, this is the grace of Bhagwan Shankar. As Lord Shiva can once more be the embodiment of peace, the Lord of life, the destroyer of all our troubles, we sing tonight. Mahapati Mahadeva ki. Shivaya Rudraya Namaha. 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 The night when we worship Mahadev, it is the final night of the Yajna. Receive the darshan of Lord Shiva, the importance of Shiva Katha, and take part in your prayer. Everybody, Shivaya Rudraya Namaha. Shivaya. Come on, boliye Shivaya. As we have been blessed to be here tonight, don't just sit there, my friends. Take the hands and clap for God. Use the avas, the voice, the speech. Sing for God and allow miracles to take place in your life. At some point in our lives, we will face sickness, illness, disease, old age, and we will die. Pray today. Pray hard, my friends, and say, Lord, when I sing your name, when I sing your glories, I will have to face these qualities of life. But I pray that you stand with me so that I don't suffer through the process of life. Shivaya Rudraya Namaha. 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 Shivaya Rudraya. Mahapati Mahadeva ki. Karaj Parishu Shankar Bhagwan ki.